हाउ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप इंक्रीजेस द प्रेशर ऑफ द फ्लूइड. Got it my point? So as we have already discussed earlier, there is an impeller which gives the rotary motion to the fluid. This is my motor, right? And this is my casing. Okay, there you can see simply. Okay, first we see here, this is my casing, this is the impeller, this is pump casing. Okay, there is, this one is my upstream flange, and this is my, so this is my suction side. Okay, and this is my discharge side. I hope you will understand it better here. Let's suppose this is my suction line and this one is my discharge line, right? So fluid will go from here. Okay, there will be strainer, there will be wall. That's I am not making here. Now what will happen that when we will start the centrifugal pump, so this impeller will rotate, right? Impeller will rotate. So as our fluid will go from the eye of the impeller, so as it is going to rotate, so what will happen that it will increase the kinetic energy of the fluid. It will increase the kinetic energy of the fluid, and as it will rotate, so at the eye it will create the vacuum. It will create the vacuum at that side, at the eye side. Okay, so what will happen means here it will create the vacuum. So what will happen that, so initially it is giving the rotary motion to the pump. Okay, because of that kinetic energy will increase. Okay, and where is the solution or this liquid is going into the eye of the pump, means from the eye of the pump the liquid is entering. Then as my impeller is rotating, so it is providing the rotary motion or kinetic energy to the fluid. Okay, now what will happen that as this fluid will go outward because of the centrifugal force, so what will happen that my fluid will go like that, my fluid will go outward like that. And what happens that the kinetic energy has increased, means velocity has increased. Now what we are doing, this is my casing. Okay, so what is the purpose of casing is that here you can see that area is, we are increasing the area gradually. Okay, we are increasing the area gradually. So what will happen that as area increases, pressure increases or velocity decreases. What will happen that ultimately the kinetic energy of the fluid will decrease and the pressure energy will increase, and we will get our fluid from the discharge side. And let's suppose the suction side fluid has a suction pressure 3 kg per centimeter square, so discharge side it may be 10 kg or something else. Got it my point? So what will happen there?